And I'm Mia. Curaçao's full of hidden gems that many locals and tourists miss. We're here to uncover those gems so you can have the full experience of Curaçao.
And today we are exploring a cave, an art cave, home to one of Curaçao's most known artists.
Follow us!
Today we are meeting with Frances Lin, poet, artist, and designer. Hi, Frances.
Hi, Mia.
Hi, Frances.
Hi, Luma.
Thank you for inviting us to your studio. It's so bright and full of color. Can we ask you some questions and learn more about you?
Of course.
Who's your favorite artist?
My favorite artist is God. I like some artists, but I like the amazing work of the creator of creators, and that's what I look to.
When I came to Curaçao, I saw this naked chicken. It was bright and colorful. So why do you paint such colorful art, and why did you paint the naked chicken?
Naked chicken, because I make it so you can ask me about it, you know, so people can ask themselves, why is the chicken naked, you know? But my point was more that We should be like that in the world, like naked, like be ourselves. That's the best thing we can do, I think.
How long does it take you to paint a mural?
It depends the big of the mural, you know, how big it is and how I feel inspired at that moment. Because my way of painting is not like painting like one layer. I paint like a lot of layers. And it depends how I feel and sometimes the weather and circumstances. Sometimes a month, sometimes two weeks, I don't know.
When did you start painting?
When? I can't remember. I guess kindergarten. I just didn't stop.
Do you have any advice for younger kids that want to be artists too?
The best thing to do as younger kids, you ask your parents to buy you everything of art. And then you do everything yourself. You YouTube a little bit and do it yourself. Do a lot of it. Do a lot of it and don't stop. Because the older you get, the more people are going to say things to you and deviate where you're going. So do it yourself. And then who knows, you may be famous before you get old.
Also, you make lots of jewelry and bags and all those types of stuff. How do you get your inspiration for those types of things?
Now, I use a lot of materials indeed, but my thing is not the material. My thing is more what I want to say. You see, if you want to say something, and so you use the right material to help you say that, just like a dance or something.
Huh. You're going to get your art expo soon. Are you excited?
Yes, I'm excited. I'm always excited. I'm excited that you guys are interviewing me. And this is like an expo also.
Thank you for inviting us to your studio. Can we make some art?
Of course. Let's make some music. What do you think about that?
Yes!
Thank you, Frances. Don't forget to visit Frances's murals.
And don't forget to check out Francis's Art Cave.
And remember, get to know your island. There's art everywhere!
I see. A beautiful forbidden island. I see. A beautiful forbidden island. Denk erom, dit is een niet gebaseerd op een waar gebeurd verhaal gedicht. Denk erom, dit is een niet gebaseerd op een waar gebeurd verhaal gedicht. A beautiful forbidden island. I see. Love is all we need for real. Voor liefde blijf je net even lang wakker. Ik zag de mooiste bloem en kocht een ticket naar Forbidden Island. Voor liefde schreef ik haar ongeveer 7 gedichten in een week. I fell in love with the Forbidden Island. Sindsdien wil ik de hele tijd naar haar toe reizen. Vanochtend vroeg schreef ik haar een bericht. Mijn voorstel spijbel je werk, zometeen naar mijn archief. We kunnen een kunstwerk maken met z'n twee. Ik ga eerst ontbijt kopen, tafel zetten, maar kunstzinnig, alsof ik het zelf heb gekookt, babe. Mijn voorstel, spijbel je werk zometeen naar mijn archief. Zie, is onrealistisch, ja, ik weet. Ik ben een kunstenaar.